It's December, and at this time of the year, the artists' open houses open for their winter season. It's a fantastic opportunity, or has been, for us to go out and do some creative Christmas shopping. I'm delighted to have Judy Stevens here in the newsroom to talk about how it works this year. Hi, Judy.
Hello.
How's it working this year?
Well, it's working a little differently this year. Obviously, we had to postpone the May Festival until now, really. But we're now going ahead with an amalgamation of the May and Christmas Festival. It launched 2 weeks ago as an online-only festival. During the lockdown period, we developed new platforms so that you can browse the artists' work online. You can go on little tours of artists' open houses from videos that they upload to their listings. But from this weekend, we're actually being able to open to the public. So about 60 houses will be opening this weekend. Some of them are opening actually today or tomorrow, and they're going to be open until the 15th of December. Unlike the usual festival, it's not only the weekend, some of them are open on weekdays as well, but you really need to look at the individual listings to see what days houses are opening.
That makes it actually a lot easier for a lot of people. Access can sometimes be difficult. Not everyone's home is wheelchair friendly.
Absolutely.
So actually, in a sense, is this something that you'll take forward into the future?
I think it has been a really, really interesting development. And, not only, absolutely, as you say, that it makes it more accessible for everybody, but also to a wider audience. So, the audience can be anywhere, basically.
Anywhere in the world.
Exactly. And we're extending the online festival until the end of the year, so that visitors in the city and the region can go to the actual open houses, but then they'll have a longer period to browse online.
And make decisions and work out how much they can afford to spend.
Exactly, so do Christmas shopping and or any other presents that you want to buy for the new year.
The great thing about the Christmas presents of the OOH is, of course, that there are things which are very affordable. The price range it comes down a little bit for this season because there are a lot more craftspeople involved.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think it's a really fantastic way to do your Christmas shopping. To buy unique and handmade presents. Some really, really beautiful things are available from the open houses. And it's also a more pleasant environment than going to crowded high street shops. All the open houses will have socially distanced, regulating visitor numbers to their houses. You can book online via Eventbrite to many of the houses.
So you can actually arrange what time you turn up and how long you're there for.
Exactly. So yeah, and each house will limit the number. They'll have PPE in place, so it'll be a really safe and nice environment for doing your Christmas shopping. And then also you'll have the similar experience by going around virtual open houses online and being able to do your Christmas shopping online.
Now, having had a look at the website, there are some fascinating tours of people's homes, but there are also brilliant people talking about how they create, the way they work.
Yeah.
That's a new departure as well.
I think it's really interesting as you say, some artists actually do take you on physical tours around their houses in a virtual way. But yes, for some, it's really explaining about the processes behind their work and also the ideas behind the work, which I think is really, really interesting for visitors.
Artists open houses, I mean, you must be 30-ish years old now. It would go on though, won't it? I mean, next year we're looking forward to a summer season in May where people, hopefully, will be able to go to people's homes again.
Well, very much hoping. I mean, things are looking, there's no wood to touch, but things are looking pretty promising. So, registration will be opening for the May Festival in January. And we're hoping that things will be more or less back to normal. Obviously, we'd still be taking precautions if necessary. And we'll probably still be keeping the online platforms as well. So, there will be new ways to experience the open houses. But hopefully, the old ways will be back as per normal as well.
Thank you so much. If you want to take a look online, it's aoh.org.uk. aoh.org.uk. And it really is wonderful. It's very entertaining. And inspiring too. Thank you very much, Judy.
Thank you.